Take a close look at the picture that is being shown on the screen. Here you will find that certain lenses have been taken. These lenses are concave lenses. Now, when a concave lens is held up in sunlight and a paper is placed in front of the concave lens, you will be interested to see that the paper does not burn. Now, why is the paper not burning? Even though we are holding up the concave lens in front of the paper and there is sunlight present, you will notice that the paper is not burning at all. Let us find out why this is happening. As you can see, this is the structure of a concave lens. In a concave lens, there are two surfaces that are curved inwards. Now, let us get to the bottom of the mystery of why the paper did not burn when we placed it in front of the concave lens. Since the sun is an object that is very far away, the rays of light that are coming from it are parallel to one another. The concave lens is also kept in such a way so that the principal axis of the concave lens, that is GH, is parallel to the incident rays. Now, here we consider two incident rays, AB and MN. These two rays are incident on the air-glass interface, that is, from a rarer medium to a denser medium. Now, since there is a change in medium, these rays will undergo refraction. Now, let's see what happens after they undergo refraction. Rays AB and MN are refracted at the interface and they bend towards the normal. That is, they move closer to the normal. Now, rays BC and NR are the refracted rays that travel inside glass or the concave lens. Now, again, these rays are incident on the second surface of the concave lens and they encounter the glass air interface. So, refraction takes place again. Since in this case the rays were incident from a denser medium to a rarer medium, after refraction the rays move away from the normal, or in other words, they shift away from the normal. Now, if you notice closely, these rays RS and CD that are emerging from the concave lens, you will find that they are not meeting at any point on the principal axis. Instead, they are moving outwards or they are diverging away. Now, since they are not meeting at any point on the principal axis, the heat that was contained in these sun rays is not focused on any point. And it is due to this that the paper placed in front of the lens was not burning. So, what exactly is happening? Concave lens, we thus conclude, is a diverging lens. And those rays which were not meeting at any point on the principal axis were diverging. Now, let us consider this ray diagram once again. You will notice that when rays CD and RS are moving outwards or diverging, they are not meeting at any point on the principal axis. But they seem to be coming from a point that lies on the object side. In other words, they seem to be diverging from this point, that is F1. F1 is termed as the first principal focus. So how can we define the first principal focus for a concave lens? The first principal focus of a concave lens is defined as a point on the principal axis of the lens such that rays of light that are parallel to the principal axis of the lens, that is, these parallel rays of light, after refraction from both the surfaces, that is surface 1 and surface 2, appear to be coming from this point. That is, these diverging rays appear to be coming from the first principal focus, or F1. So likewise, we have another term, that is the second principal focus. What is the second principal focus? In this ray diagram, you will find that rays BC and SR are incident on the concave lens. Now, they are incident in such a way that they appear to be meeting at point F2. In other words, they are incident in such a way that they appear to be incident at this point. And after refraction from both the surfaces, these rays are becoming parallel to the principal axis. So how can we define F2? We can define F2, or the second principal focus, as a point on the principal axis of the lens such that the rays of light appearing to meet at the point, that is DC and SR, that are appearing to meet at this point F2, after refraction from both these surfaces, become parallel to the principal axis of the lens. In other words, rays DC and SR, after refraction, become parallel to the principal axis. And the point where they appeared to meet or tended to meet is known as the second principal focus, denoted by F2. Now, we have defined the first principal focus of the concave lens. Now, what do you think is the focal length of a concave lens? The focal length of a concave lens is conventionally defined as the distance in between F1 and the optical center of the concave lens. And the focal length is usually denoted by the letter F. If the two curved surfaces have an equal radius of curvature, then the distance between O and F1 and O and F2 will be equal. Now let me tell you something interesting. Notice the picture on the board. Can you tell me what this hole is? You will be interested to learn that this is the peephole or the eye hole in a door. Now, do you know what purpose it serves? If you place your eyes at the peephole or the eye hole, you will observe that you are able to obtain a very wide view of the outside of the door. Now, do you know what is being used over here? It is certainly not a plane object, because if this transparent medium was plane, then such a wide view would not have been possible. Thus, the object that is being used is a concave lens. Why? Because when rays of light from the outside are incident on this concave lens, they diverge. And due to this diverging, when these rays enter your eyes, you get and you are able to see a wide view of the outside. And this actually is a safety measure, because you are able to obtain such a wide view of the outside, and you can easily say who is standing outside if you place your eyes at the eye hole. So, recapitulating, what did we learn? We learned that concave lens is a diverging lens. In a concave lens, we have two foci, the first principal focus and the second principal focus. The first principal focus was defined as that point on the principal axis after which parallel rays of light after refraction from both the surfaces appeared to be diverging from this point. And the second principal focus was that point at which rays of light appeared to be incident or appeared to meet, and after refraction they become parallel to the principal axis. We also defined focal length of a concave lens. The focal length of a concave lens is conventionally defined as the distance in between F1, that is the first principal focus, and O, the optical center of the concave lens.